I just finished 24 days of blind whiskey tastings. There's a link in the description below for those episodes. So it feels really weird to know the whiskey that I'm going to be pouring and tasting. And frankly, I'm kind of stoked about it. Let's do this. Welcome to Whiskey Riffs. If you're new here, I'm Kevin, and thank you for visiting and watching this video. Today, I have a whiskey that I've been dying to open up, but I got it just before the December Advent calendar. This bottle's just sitting there unopened, and I'm just thrilled to be able to open it today. This is an expression from Cavillon, and it's part of their Concert Master series. This is the port cask finish. It's bottled at 43% ABV. I haven't tried it yet. It's unopened, so I'm gonna open it now, pour some in a glass so we can check out the flavors. This whiskey has natural coloring and it could have chill filtration because it is below the 46% ABV mark. It's down at 43% and they don't say anything about chill filtration. Their higher ABV expressions don't have any chill filtration and they don't have any coloring. So the coloring is probably natural. This whiskey is matured in American oak, and then it's finished off in port casks from Portugal. Three different types, tawny, ruby, and vintage port casks. The Cavillon Distillery was founded in 2005. It's located in Yilan County, Taiwan, which has a subtropical climate. That means that this whiskey is matured in a very hot and humid place. This location was picked because it has great water sources. And as you know, water is such a critical part of any whiskey that anytime you can get water that is coming from a clean mountain source like the Snowy Mountains or Central Mountains of Taiwan, that's a good thing for a whiskey. Cavillon has two maturation warehouses. Both are 5 stories high, which is going to give you a difference in the type of maturation that happens at each level. There's certainly differences in Tennessee and Kentucky warehouses. They find sweet spots in a warehouse, in a rick house. And I would imagine that this 5-story monstrosity in a subtropical climate is also going to give you a lot of nuances in the different types of casks that are floating around that, or those two buildings actually. Well, I've been waiting a long time to nose this whiskey and find out a little bit more about it. I've heard good things and I've heard some criticism, so I'll try to wipe those out and start on my own with this. Now, I like the nose, but I am partial to finished whiskeys. I do tend to like port finished whiskeys, if you know my love of the Quinta Rubin, one of my favorites, and this might be one of my favorites if the ABV holds up. Now, this is a non-age statement whiskey. Because it's such a hot and humid climate, it's much like the Kentucky and Texas and hotter climate American whiskeys where they mature quicker. So this color, it might be only 2 or 3 years old, might be even a little bit longer. They don't state that either, but the color is gonna come quickly in those kind of climates compared to someplace like Scotland, where that cold climate isn't going to give you that movement in the wood, so you don't get the color very quickly in the whiskey. First thing that hits me when I nose this is cloves. It's a little bit of spiciness. I can get some vanilla below that. And I just got like a grape soda. Yeah, kind of an artificial grape. Kind of expecting more of wine grapes, but it's sweeter than that. I like the fruitiness. I like the nose right off the bat. I get some malty notes in there. This is so far going really well. And for me, I'm getting some brighter fruits. In addition to the grapes, I'm getting some apple notes. I like that clove spice mixed with the sweetness. That's a really nice nosing. Some decent oak spice right off the bat in the first taste. I imagine that's because of the warm environment. Ooh, nice long finish. That's really nice. The finish is sweet and then cinnamon. The cinnamon lingers around after the initial swallow. And it sounds weird, but now when I nose it, I want to say taffy, which it's not that sweet, so I don't know why I'm getting taffy notes. Maybe like a saltwater taffy. Maybe I'm getting some of the briny, salty breeze that's coming through from the sea. It's more sweet on the nose than it is on the taste. And there's a lot of cinnamon spice. I'm getting some of the port flavors and the fruits from that, but I'm also getting a lot of pepper and cinnamon, and it's a lot spicier than I thought it was going to be. This could have a lot to do with the warmer, humid climate, and it's working that wood, so you're getting a lot of that spices from the wood that you wouldn't normally get in a colder climate. I'm trying to figure out if I just like this or if I really love it. It's okay right now for me. I'm kind of enjoying it. Maybe I'm just enjoying it because I actually know what I'm drinking for once in weeks. It's been a whole month of December that I haven't had any knowledge of the whiskey that I've been tasting. Very stressful. I really do like the blend. Yeah, even though it's really spicy, I think the sweet notes are pulling me back in, but every taste has given me even more of that pepper and cinnamon, because that's what you're left with. So you get the sweetness, you get some of the port notes, and then you get the spice. Now their notes say a bit of brown sugar, or notes I read earlier, and I'm getting a little bit of the sweetness, but again, for me, it tends to come in that artificial grape flavor or a taffy grape. Is there grape taffy? I don't know. But it tastes something like that to me. And then, of course, that's all wiped out by the spices. So what are my recommendations on the Cavillon? Well, it's a low ABV whiskey. It is non-age statement, so we don't know how old this one is. There are other Cavillon expressions that looked even more interesting than this, but unfortunately, they can be hard to get. I have had trouble getting these. I'll have to look again and see if I can get some good prices on the other ones, because now I'm interested in some of their higher ABV offerings. This bottle I paid $70 for locally in San Francisco. I've seen it in other places around me for about $98. So I'm guessing that if you can find it, you might find a wide range of prices on it, depending on how well their distribution is. But I think if you enjoy port finished whiskeys, if you're looking for something that's a little bit different, it's matured in traditional Scottish techniques, pot stills, double distillation, and of course the maturation in oak, but it's such a hot environment that it's gonna give you different flavor notes than you would get from a Scotch. And if you like a little spice, a little cinnamon spice, if you like a little of that pepper spice in your tasting notes, this is definitely a good whiskey for that. And frankly, I'm just thrilled to be doing full episodes again and being able to share a single whiskey with you and talk about that whiskey. And if you've enjoyed this video, if you've enjoyed coming back to the single expression videos, why don't you give this video a like, please? It really helps spread it around YouTube. And this is New Year's Eve when I'm publishing this, so have a very happy new year, and hopefully 2022 is going to be a wonderful year. Fingers crossed, there's a lot of stress and strain going into it, but together I think we can get through this. So until the next episode, take care of yourself. Take care of those people around you, and cheers. This is an expression from Cavillon. It's the concert master. This is an expression from Cavillon. It's the Concert Master series, the port cask finished. I can't talk today. Concert Master port cask finish. I haven't had a sip yet, so no excuses. Cavillon has two maturation warehouse.